completely off guard, and it's not your fault. Truth is, it's not even because of the coronavirus pandemic either. The real reason is lies. The World Health Organization and the media told us this is just a flu and it will be contained. These lies have already cost the lives of thousands of people, and the death toll might reach hundreds of thousands in the coming weeks. For 2 months now, I've been trying to warn the American people of what's coming. Due to my work, I had access to inside information from the epicenter of the outbreak, and I knew this was going to be a life-changing event for our country. Most have called me crazy or paranoid. But despite all of this, I'm thankful to say that over 1,000 American families listened and took the action needed at the right time. The knowledge in this presentation has helped them keep calm and prepare in time for the coming disaster. The good news is that you still have some time to do the same thing. The bad news is that it is ticking away fast. That's why you need to stop everything you're doing right now and pay very close attention. Because in the next few minutes, I'm going to blow the lid on 5 very dangerous lies going around. But why should you listen to me? My name is Stuart Adams. I've been an investigative journalist for over 23 years, and I've spent most of my life getting reporting on major disease outbreaks around the world. For me, it was personal. I lost my father to encephalitis when I was only 15, and that changed my life completely. I've reported from the front lines during the outbreaks of swine flu, avian flu, SARS, MERS, and even Ebola. And when I saw the images coming out of Wuhan, China in January, I knew I had to do something to warn the American people. I knew it would spread here, too. In fact, we are already in the hoarding phase as thousands of terrified Americans grab anything they can get their hands on from stores all across our country. Unfortunately, they are spending their hard-earned money on the wrong supplies. I will tell you why in a few moments. But first, you need to see through the 5 lies out there that will make this pandemic even more deadly and dangerous. So, let's get right to it. The virus will go away by summer. Take a look at this chart. This shows the number of deaths caused by the first well-documented flu pandemic, the Spanish influenza. The disease was spotted first in spring 1918, but the most deaths and infections occurred in the fall of that same year. After the relative quiet of the summer months, the second wave that came during October and November was much more deadly and devastating. This nCoV-19 virus is transmitted similarly to influenza viruses, yet its infection rate is 2 to 3 times higher. Which means that the same pattern of infection and death will apply to it, too. It held true for the H1N1 swine flu that swept through the world in 2009, and the H5N1 avian flu that swept through the world in 2003. One thing is clear. The second wave of infection is much more devastating than the first outbreak. As bad as things are right now, everything will be much worse in October and November. This disease won't be gone come summer. In fact, it will come back with a vengeance. Judging by the numbers coming out from Italy, we could possibly see more than 1 million dead and 3 million Americans needing intensive care. Unfortunately, this projection might not show the real extent of the danger. It's time to look at the second lie we're being told. Only the elderly are at serious risk from this disease. Both French and Dutch medical professionals are reporting that half of coronavirus patients currently in intensive care units are under the age of 60 and 50 years old, respectively. In fact, there is a widely known case of a 16-year-old boy that was diagnosed with a virus and had no disclosed underlying conditions, yet wound up in the intensive care unit. Unfortunately for us, there are 3 more serious complications that are specific to the U.S. 39.6% of Americans are obese. 30.3 million Americans have diabetes. 121.5 million Americans have medical issues related to heart or blood vessel disease. All of these conditions make an infection with this coronavirus far more serious. Our intensive care units will be overwhelmed. Moving on to the next lie. If you're healthy, completely healthy, you have nothing to worry about. I spoke to a respiratory therapist whose job is to ensure that patients are breathing well. He works in a medium-sized hospital's intensive care unit near New Orleans. I'm withholding his name and employer as he fears retaliation. He told me, quote, reading about it in the news, I knew it was going to be bad. But we deal with the flu every year, so I was thinking, well, it's probably not much worse than the flu. But seeing patients with COVID-19 completely changed my perspective, and it's a lot more frightening. This is knocking out what should be perfectly fit, healthy people. I've had patients in their early 40s, and yeah, I was kind of shocked. I'm seeing people who look relatively healthy with a minimal health history, and they are completely wiped out like they've been hit by a truck. This is knocking out what should be perfectly fit, healthy people. Patients will be on minimal support, on a little oxygen, and then all of a sudden, they go into complete respiratory arrest, shut down, and can't breathe at all. End of quote. Even former Olympic athletes are suffering. Former Olympic gold medalist Cameron Vandenberg, who is battling COVID-19, has issued a warning about the impact that coronavirus can have on the body. By far the worst virus I've ever endured, in spite being a healthy individual with strong lungs, no smoking, living a healthy lifestyle, and being young, the least at-risk demographic, the 31-year-old tweeted. Again, we're talking about a former Olympic gold medalist here, not your average Joe. There's still one more we have to address here. The people who've recovered from the disease. Yes, there are tens of thousands counted in the statistics right now, which might make you think that you can be fully healed from COVID-19. Recent findings.